is that there's always a path to power. There's always, no matter what it looks like, no matter where you are, no matter what stage of life, there's always a pathway to power. My prayer has been that hopefully I can give you some tools, and if I can just encourage one person not to quit, not to throw in the towel, not to turn back, not to fold up shop and just quit. If I can just encourage one person, I know that my job has been, it's all been worth it. And so my prayer is that as we continue to move forward, that we realize truly that we have a pathway to power. And I'll continue to tell you that over and over again until people believe it. One of the hardest things as being a believer, being a Christian, is seeing people who have access to power and not using it. It's seeing people walk around defeated, not understand that they have access to power. They don't have to walk around that way. See people being discouraged when they should be encouraged. See people being sorrowful when they should be walking around in joy. Realize we have a pathway to power. You know, the first week I talked about in this Stronger series talking about the strength not to slip. Then week two, we talked about the strength after a fall. Last week, we talked about having the strength to stand. And we know, just to recap really quickly, we said that in order to stand, you need to make sure that everyone may not know why you're standing, but you must stand. That's one thing we have to understand, that we had talked about last week. And also we talked about that the strength is for your position and your transition. So where you are and where you're going, the strength that you have is for your position and your transition. We talked about how Joshua ordered his officers and told them, get up and get ready. And that's what we talked about a little bit last week, about getting assigned to get up and get ready. Because when God moves, when God is ready, that's not the time to start trying to get prepared. We need to already be prepared for what God is trying to do. So we need to make sure that we're already up and already ready to go. Amen? You said, the strength that you need is for the opposition, because we did talk about that there will be opposition. We talked about Daniel. I asked you, can you remain godly in an ungodly situation? That was a challenge to everyone. How can you remain godly in an ungodly situation? Many times we conform to whatever situation that we're in. If you've ever been around depressed people, you find yourself depressed. If you've ever been around someone who's happy, you find yourself being happy. We are so emotionally sensitive to our environment. That's why we have to be very, very careful that if we're in an ungodly situation, many times we may operate outside of our character. That's why environment is so important. So can you remain godly in an ungodly situation? And number four, I told you, is that the strength that you have, the strength that we need, is the strength to pass. The strength to pass, whatever the test is. We talked about the woman of the issue of blood and how she had to stand. We talked about Jairus and how he had to stand. And we talked about the process, and none of us like going through the process, but I told y'all that the process is the point. The process is the point. There's a big difference from those who were given something versus those who earned something. Huge difference. Because if you are given something, you have less appreciation for what the gift that someone gave you. However, if you earn something, you feel a little bit more gratitude for what you earn. And that's what I talk about. That's the people who have experience, who have gone through life, who've had trials and tribulations, have gone through things. They appreciate when they come out on the other side just a little bit more than those who maybe have had smooth sailing the entire time, their entire life. You appreciate it more, right? Because you have so much more experience and emotion to attach to them. So we talked about those strokes. We talked about how we need to make sure that we're enduring and surviving, and just how great God can move on our situation. And anytime that we think that something's impossible, that's not impossible. It may be impossible for us, but it's not impossible for Him. And God sometimes just waits for us to get at the end of our rope. So we say, okay, are you done? Is you finished? Or is y'all done? I'm here. Now this is the opportunity, this is the environment conducive for me to show you how great and how powerful I am. Because if you were so strong, if you were so mighty, then what's the point of Him going on the cross and dying for us? If you could save yourself. And sometimes we have to get to the end of self in order for Him to really show me, what He is capable of doing. So again, we talked about the strength of, not to slip. We talked about the strength after the fall. We talked about the strength to stand. And today I want to talk to you about the strength to go forward.